Honorable Speaker, sir. Sir, I just want to seek some few clarifications from the Honorable Chief Minister Saab regarding this skill development bill and the skill university which has been proposed by the government, sir. Sir, firstly, इससे पहले कि मैं अपने सवालात को आपके जरिए हुकूमत के सामने रखूं, मैं ये बात जरूर कहना चाहूंगा कि सर, इन माय पर्सनल कैपेसिटी, फ्रॉम माय पर्सनल अर्निंग्स, फ्रॉम माय पर्सनल पॉकेट, आई रन 10 स्कूल सर, वेयर ऑलमोस्ट 25,000 चिल्ड्रन आर बीन प्रोवाइडेड विथ फ्री एजुकेशन. And in all the schools, I also run vocational training courses, where this house might be surprised. With all responsibility, I am saying, sir, up till now, in last 20 years, I have trained 2.5 lakh women, sir. And every 6 months, sir, we have a course. We have a course of a spoken English, we have computer course, we have fashion designing course, we have a sewing course, multimedia course, GST course, accounting course, and we have some 22 courses like this. And after completion of the course, what we do is, sir, like a woman has completed a fashion designing course or a sewing course. So from my personal trust, not from MIM, sir, we provide them with a sewing machine. We also have a beauty parlor training centers where we train them for beauty parlors, sir, for ladies. We provide them with a beauty parlor kit also worth some 1500 rupees, where it has a scissors, the brush, the hair dryer and everything. Mehndi designing, sir. Hyderabadis, we have also Mehndi designing, so we provide that also. So there are many courses, so I have a good knowledge in this, sir. And at the same time, sir, the MIM party runs 2 hospitals. Sir, in that 2 hospitals, the teaching hospital. Sir, in collaboration with my trust and MIM's trust, in healthcare sector, sir, sir, there is a dialysis technician, CT scan technician, MRI technician, respiratory therapist technician training is there. Then we have operation theater training, X-ray technician is there. Sir, I just want to bring to your kind notice through you to the government is that, sir, already the health university is providing such cases. Sir, in Andhra Pradesh, sir, NTR University was there, then later on it was named as YS, now in Andhra Pradesh. Sir, after the formation of Telangana, we have been repeatedly requesting the health university to start such courses. Sir, now what is happening is that, sir, what we need to take into consideration and the important point is that, sir, a student does a graduation for 3 years. Now the question arises, the government of India is saying that graduation studies has to be for 4 years. Now my question is, sir, when we are providing a skill development course, the duration has to be smaller. If it is a 3 years course or a 4 years course, the students are not enrolling themselves. So we have to look into this aspect also. This is a very important. Diploma courses are there, sir. They are too short. The problem arises is what, sir? There are many courses which are not recognized by the government of India. And after, sir, health university is also offering a course. They started, I went And I met the VC, I requested, gave a letter. Then they said, sir, we'll start BSc lab technician, BSc MRI technician, BSc CT scan. The problem is, sir, 3 years he has to study. So 3 years become a very long period. And after the studying for 3 years, sir, the saddest part is that he has a degree and the degree is not recognized in the international world. Here the problem arises. Sir, we need to make sure that whatever degrees and whatever diplomas that we are going to give to these children, those diplomas and those degrees should be recognized by the international technical or technology or skill development boards. This is very important. This has not been done. And Honorable Speaker, sir, for your kind information, Government of India is also running such courses.